Welcome back to Game Does Play Games, where we play games, talk game design, and we play Overland, and then rocks are floating in the air.
I think this is a bug, which...
I don't know, man. There is a lot of wind. See the wind going by?
Yeah, sure. We'll justify it that way. I mean, unless this is an actual mechanic. See, the weird thing is that, you know, we have to drive the car across... this area, so...
Can you pick up the stick?
Unless I can move these rocks. It looks like I can push them. Maybe that is a legit thing. What? I don't understand.
What does this game become?
I don't understand why they're floating.
Just start pushing rocks. Push rocks.
I'm going to push rocks. Okay, I'll push rocks.
No, not that way. What are you doing?
I'm trying to
move it. You got to move it off the road. Chris, I think I know a little bit more about this game than you.
It's probably true.
I never played this game.
No. You
come on. Move the rocks. What are you even doing?
I gotta fill the car.
Why didn't you fill it up before you left?
I couldn't. You can't fill it up at the campsite.
That is not my fault. Go, Poochie.
Poochie,
move the rocks.
It's not how it works. Poochie's just going to go over here.
I think it's fun watching Poochie's face, the bottom right, where his portrait is, while he's moving around.
I'm going to drop this here because... Wait. She has more energy.
What?
She has 3 now.
What?
Oh, no. This is the car. Never mind. Sorry. UI is confusing sometimes. So I guess I will pull this? Yeah. That seems logical. Is this supposed to be a floating rock? I still don't understand. Like, really?
You know what would help us understand is if we went on YouTube and watched some videos of people playing to see what their reaction was.
If we all react the same, then something is probably up. We could all be wrong, though, so who really knows?
I mean... On the plus side, look at it this way. Those are big rocks. If they weren't floating, you probably wouldn't be able to move them.
That's true. That's absolutely true. Hey, look. I got a... Wait, are you holding both of these? No. There you go. Hey, I have another health pack.
You didn't even use the other one.
Yeah, but I dropped it. Oh, wait, no, I did pick it back up, didn't I? Sorry, we took a little break in between episodes.
Got fat. Can you push the rock that isn't floating?
Ooh, that's a good question. No, I cannot.
Huh.
Wait, wrong character.
You should push that rock forward 2 squares.
Yes, that is my plan.
Maybe just 1 square first, and then the next turn another square, if possible.
Wait!
Because you're...
Hold on. Okay. So the floating rock must be intentional, because you can push these, and it does not create noise, which draws more monsters. So it is an intentional choice. A very strange intentional choice, but it's definitely on purpose.
Maybe the world's falling apart.
That must be kind of what the idea is. I feel like they need something aesthetically to better represent it. And I mean, this is probably placeholder, right? Because this is alpha of all things.
Yeah.
Maybe
it's like the mines. Maybe it's like some foreign object thing that's not supposed to be just, you know, exist.
Yeah, it could be something like
or
that.
Or maybe they're really heavy balloons. Ugh.
I don't think that's how balloons work, but...
I think you wouldn't know.
That's true, I wouldn't
know. If you push the rock again, you can get out.
I know. I'm actually going to keep these rocks here so that these guys can't get me, and I'm instead going to search in this bin.
So viewers, a long time ago... I was running a campaign. We play RPGs a lot, and I was running a campaign for a game called Rifts.
No, I didn't want to do that.
And in it, there was a bad guy NPC I made up that he was called Elemental Fusionist, and he would combine earth and wind magic together to do things.
All right, I can just drive in between rocks. I think that's definitely something else that's.
It's because they were floating. Oh, wait, no, that was a floating one. So anyway, so this elemental fusionist, he could fly on a rock. And at some point, there was confusion in the campaign as the character wanted to attack him or do something. And they're like, what do you mean I can't, like, what do you mean I can't get him or reach him? Or what do you, oh yeah, it was, what do you mean I can't catch him? And I was like, he's on his rock. And they're like, oh, yeah, well, of course that makes sense.
Immediately everyone's like, oh,
right.
Yeah,
he's on his rock. And I was like, oh, games, that's the only time you'd ever hear that type of sentence ever muttered, and it make a lot of sense.
That is a very, like, that's a perfect story to, like, I don't know, as an example of,
like... To ruin the moment with?
Yeah, sure. No, I like that story a lot. I mean, I was there for it, so I guess I'm partial to it.
It kind of, you know, describes gaming in a nutshell in some ways.
Yeah, I think that's why I like it so much. It's kind of charming in that regard.
God, that was so long ago.
Yeah.
That was 10 years ago, almost. Almost 10 years ago.
Oh, God.
Right? Dude.
Yeah, now our audience knows how old we are, which is really not that old.
Not very old.
But, man.
I mean, if I were older, I'd be more powerful, so.
It's true. I don't trust anything right now. I hate these guys. Okay, so if you don't remember from our first run through this, these guys move two spaces, which throws everything out of whack. But
can they move and attack?
They can move once and attack, yes.
Okay, so they can't move twice and attack, but they can. Okay, so basically they have two actions.
Yeah. We did get some really good responses from our earlier questions of the day regarding, like, what kind of monsters would people create for this game.
What were the responses?
One of our fans came up with, I think, like, four different monsters.
Good for you.
Yeah, no, I love it when we get responses like that. And some of them were things that I kind of considered as a possibility, too. Things like, why can't I feel? Oh, because I'm not actually carrying this.
Having strokes?
Yeah, a little bit. Things like a monster that can move like three spaces, but can only move in one direction and has to move those three. Like if it hits a wall,
like
it just stops.
Charges straight at you.
Yeah, and I was like, okay, that's actually a really good limitation because being able to move three times is already just incredibly broken. But if, you know, if they could like move twice and attack, then the player will just never live ever.
Yeah. So you can sidestep them.
Mm-hmm.
That'd be pretty cool.
I don't remember a ton of the other ones, though, but I should look back in some of the older comments and see what people
suggested. We should stop recording this episode and go look and then come back and be like, oh, we knew the whole time. What do the two-headed monsters do?
They attack twice, I believe.
Oh.
Or they just deal more damage. They definitely have more health.
Have like two health anyway, so dealing more damage would be equivalent of attacking twice.
I think they just
have more health.
Have more health because they do take two attacks to kill.
Mm.
This is not
Spider Walker is going to be a problem if you don't kill him. You should just kill him.
No, because he's too close to everyone. I'm actually going to Oh, these guys can't reach him. I'm going to take a huge risk if I do that. I'm just going to. Oh, that's right. I forgot that these things damage you. I almost ended my turn up there.
I remember the one time you just, like, that one character just died.
And I was like,
yeah.
What happened? Yeah, good times. What are you carrying right now, Poochie?
Gas.
Can I rotate this? I don't remember. Guess not.
Pretty sure it's a gas canister.
Want you to carry this med kit. Okay, good. So I'm going to move him up here. You are going to grab this.
Kapalza.
And let's see, 1, 2. We're going to keep everyone buddied up. It's too bad that there's no, like... Well, I guess that would be very Banner Saga. I guess I have Banner Saga on the mind. This is the second time I've brought it up during this playthrough. It's like a shame that we can't, like... have adjacent characters have some kind of like defensive benefit, but I guess if one of us has like one of those like wooden pallets,
you kind of
already kind
of
does that.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I mean, defensive abilities or offensive, it would be cool if they had abilities at all, Chris, but no, this is a survival game.
Oh shit,
it's not about fighting hordes of whatever these things are.
Oh, I already messed up.
Or dredge, or.
Okay.
You messed up. You messed up. Oh, because you can't move into the creepy grass. Kill the thing.
Wait, can I even... I can't damage this guy.
What? Why?
I don't know.
Do you not have a weapon to damage him with?
Unless those guys can't be damaged. But that would be kind of strange.
That would be strange.
We're going to move you here. Okay, well, Poochie can at least attack you and kill you. We're going to do that. That's good. I'm glad that Boom. These guys only have one health. Oh, you can drag bodies. Okay, so then that kind of fixes the one issue that I brought up in the last episode.
Where you get just surrounded by bodies.
Mm-hmm. I didn't think that was an option before, but...
But the funny part is, now that you did that, you're completely safe. Oh, he can walk right over it.
Oh.
And
so
your character got attacked.
Yeah, that was when... I knew that was going to happen. That's why I was like, oh, I goofed up. But those guys can only move one turn or one space at a time, so it could be worse. Can you attack him? No, you can only drag that body. That's weird. Oh, but I can kill you. Damn, Poochie.
Poochie is so strong.
Okay, so now we need to get you guys out of here. Drag or drag? Oh, because there are two bodies here. Fantastic.
I feel like this is probably one of the most, like, least entertaining episodes of anything we've ever done. It's been very analytical.
Sorry, guys.
but we are just about out of time.
Okay.
So, question of the day.
Yes. I'm going to keep poking around while you do this.
While I struggle to find a question of the day. There's a lot of things with movement and stuff today. Oh, you know what? Let's just talk about... I think we should talk about the floating rocks.
Actually, yeah. I kind of like that because it's the first time we've seen an obstacle that can be moved without actually creating any sound.
Yeah.
And that's I think, right now, aside from, like, it seeming kind of like a placeholder asset. Sorry, guys, if it's not. I don't really know. It's Alpha, I'm assuming. But that kind of changes. It actually is a thing that is making the game easier for the player rather than more difficult.
It offered a new challenge, but at the same time, it did bring up... Yeah, it did. It brought in a new mechanic that was different, or rather, the new mechanic being not making noise.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. That is strange.
Right?
That it didn't offer more difficulty, but actually aided the player.
I suppose in another sense, though, it does mean that the designers can use them more to block the player without it being too penalizing. So it's a good in-between. It's still an obstacle, but it's not as severe as an obstacle.
So I guess that should be the question today. What do you think of them adding that new element to the game, the moving floating rocks that do not create sound?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think of them adding that new element to the game that didn't actually make things more challenging, just offered more options?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess, like, to answer the question, just, like, what do you think it's doing for the game in general? Like... I guess, to make the question a little bit more specific.
Whatever, my question wasn't good enough, I guess.
He does this to me all the time, too. Don't worry, guys.
Alright, guys. Well, thanks for watching. Please vote.
For what you want to see next in this little voting thing.
Do that. And we'll see you next time on GDPG.
Thanks, guys.
Bye.